Let's program and be creative. It's time for MIT App Inventor. In this video, we're going to complete our lyrics game. We're focusing on Big Idea 2 for AP Computer Science Principle, Data. Topic 2.2, which is data compression, 2.3, extracting information using data, and 2.4, using programs with data. So in our game, we have a lyrics game, and we're taking common songs, popular songs, and compressing the lyrics based on the words that are duplicated. You can see on the class page, I gave you some media to use. These are the songs and the information that we're going to be using. That had the song, the artist, a video link that we're gonna show when the user guesses it correctly. It also has the lyrics that has multiple words duplicated. You can see we have all these things here. In the previous classes, I gave you my images of what the app will look like. So you can see this is the home screen. And using the image, you should have been able to build this out and design it on your own because we have built a bunch of apps this school year. This is the second screen, which is where you're actually going to play the game. And again, I gave you the picture of this on day one because you should be able to build this out on your own. You can look at the components window and see the things that I've added in here and kind of format it. On day one, I also gave you my code, and this is the completed code. Again, since we've built so many apps this year, you should be able to simply follow this code and build out the app on your own. On day two, for the people that were struggling, this is the video I created to show you exactly how to design the home screen and the game screen. In the previous videos, I showed you how to get up to this point, which we've encoded the lyrics. We used data compression to compress the similar words inside of lyrics. We've also created different procedures to decompress those lyrics. So again, here's our app, and again, here's our code. In the previous video, I showed you how to compress lyrics by the same word. Now, I also showed you how to decompress the lyrics by that same thing. So here is an example. If I click on new,
I have added this word me. What song is this?
You can see I have 21 hints. So 21 words have been compressed.
Hint, I have added this word girls. What song is this? Hint, I have hint. I have added this word when. What song is this?
So you can see it keeps adding.
Hint, hint. I have added this word you.
And you can keep going. The only part we have left is this part. Guess the song, speech recognizer, and that's pretty much it. Speech recognizer is pretty simple. It's what you do when you press this button. It'll listen to you. Whatever word you say, it'll grab that. And you can do something with that text, the words that you say. So let's do that. Then let's do our simple check if the song is correct. And we will be done with this. All right, so let's just build that over here. So at the top, we have this little image. When someone touches this guy here, and I don't think I made that clickable. I didn't, so make sure you do.
Hint, I have added this word I. That song is hint, hint. I have added this word baby. That song is this.
So all we're gonna do is we have to figure out why this is. Let's see if that happens again.
Hint, 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 hint. I have hint. I have added this word watch. What song is this?
There we go. All right. So for when someone clicks on this now, we're going to launch our speech recognizer. So I'm going to click on speech recognizer here. I'm going to call get text. It's going to listen. And we have these two blocks, before getting text and after getting text. After getting text, it gets a result or a partial result. This is the text. All we're going to do is when someone, really simple, when if you push on this, you can say the name of the song and we'll put it in this text box here. So Very simple TBX song name. I'm gonna pull this in here and put that there. Now, it's not gonna work on an emulator. So if I press on this, you can see no activity to handle the intent. It will not work in the emulator. But if you have a phone or tablet, you can click on this. It'll listen to you. You'll say the words or the song name and it'll show it right here. If you watch my design video, it'll show you that actually working. All right, let's work on the guest part. So when someone presses this guest part, we're gonna check this with the song name. So let's pull this button out. And as always, let's do everything in a procedure. And I'm gonna call this procedure check answer. And I simply will pull check answer and put that in there. All right, check answer. What are we doing in check answer? Got a couple different things we need to do. So what are we doing in check answer? Let's add our comment. Got a bunch of stuff we need to do inside of here. So I'm gonna check if the user guess is correct song name. One, if the guess is correct, and two, if the guess is incorrect. Pretty simple if it's incorrect. We're just gonna speak to the user and we'll say incorrect. And B, clear the text box guest song for user to type a new song. That's easy for two. For one, what we're gonna do is, if it's correct, we're gonna get the lyrics from song and lyrics dictionary using the song name. B, we're gonna get the video URL from song and video links dictionary using song name. C, we're gonna update the web viewer with the video URL. And D, we're gonna show the web viewer. And then E, we need to update the display. Anything else we need to do? Let's say button hint. Let's say update button hint to say you win. And let's always speak to the user. So that's what we're gonna do. And we will be done. All right, so if the guess is correct, so this is where they're typing, and we know what the song name is because we saved it as a variable, so we can check that. So we're gonna go to control, pull in our if statement. I'm gonna pull this in, say equals, I'm gonna get my song name that we saved. And if it's equal to whatever the user typed in, and what they typed in is the text. Now, they might type, the song name might be lowercase, and they might type it in all caps. So let's just make them both to be fair, so the user doesn't have to worry about case. I'm gonna make both of these uppercase. That way, if they type God's plan lowercase, and I have God's plan that looks like this, our wobble, see how God's plan looks like this. I'm just gonna capitalize it that way, no matter what they type in. If it's the same, then they will get it correct. All right. So if it's correct or else, it's not. If it's not, it's pretty simple. Speak to the user and correct and clear the thing. So let's do that. Get that out of the way. Speak to the user. We'll say incorrect. And let's clear out that song name area. So I'm simply going to grab the text. And I'm going to put an empty text box in there. That goes down here. That is all you need for part two. Part one's a little bit more difficult. So get the lyrics from song and lyrics using the song name. So right now this is lyrics. We actually want to update this and erase all of the little spaces. We're not going to do that by going through and looking up all the stuff. We're simply just going to grab it from our dictionary. So I'm going to say lyrics is now, let's go to our dictionary, get value for key. What is the key? It's our song name. What is the dictionary? It is our song and lyrics. So remember, if we go back up here, I have the lyrics right here. And all I'm providing is a song name and it'll give me the lyrics. So I don't have to go through each one of these. I can just simply look it up. All right. Get the video URL from song and lyrics. Now, I could put it right in here. So web, and I could use go to URL. And I could put it right in here, but let's use a local variable so we're just a little bit more clear. So I'm going to click on variables. I'm going to pull in a local variable. And let's call it video URL. I'm also going to do a get. The key is also the song name, but the dictionary is song and video links. So if we go back up, this song and video links, you have the song name and you have the video that we're going to play, which is that song. So I'm going to put this in here and then now put that here. So just so you're clear on this, I made a local variable that way you know, hey, this is what I'm grabbing. I'm getting the video URL. I'm going to put it in there. Now I simply want to show the video. Well, earlier we made a procedure called show video. And to show it, I need to pass in true. Yes, do you want to show it? True, yes I do. All right, that is D, update the display. We have a procedure that we made called update display. Update button hint to say you win. So that button here, we're just going to change that to say, fill it in with text, you win. And we want to speak to the user, right? So let's speak. And let's put a join statement text. And I'm going to say, you win. The song is. And I'm just going to have the song name. And with that, we are done. This should, when someone press guess song, it calls this and we will do this. So this is just watch. Let's see.
I have added this word to. What song is this?
To. Just watch.
Hint. I have added this word. Hint. I have added this word from. What song is this?
This is Uptown Funk. So if we type Uptown Funk. And I press guess.
You win. The song is Uptown Funk.
And you can see it shows up here. And I can press play. Now it'll say these same words. Girl sent you hallelujah. Girl sent you hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. See all the words that are duplicated? Don't believe me, just watch. So, if I click on this...
I have added this word purple. What song is this?
Oh, this is Purple Rain. I know this. Purple Rain.
You win. The song is Purple Rain.
And you can see down here, here are the lyrics that are going to be repeated. I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain, purple rain. I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Let's try a new song. So I'm gonna stop this.
Hint. I have added this word level. What song is this?
So this is level up. It's really simple.
Hint. I have added a hint. I have added this word three. Hint. I have added this word watch. What song is this?
This is level up.
You win. The song is level up.
And again, you can see. You can...
Hint. I have added this word fun. What song, Kind? I have added this word yay. What song is this?
This is Girls Like You.
Incorrect.
Uh-oh.
Kind. I have added Kind. I have Kind. Kind. I have Kind. I have added this Kind. I have added this word down.
Girl, what song is like this? You.
You win. The song is Girl Like You.
There we go. And you can see. So, there you go. This is our really simple app focusing on Big Idea 2, data from AP Computer Science Principles. We covered the entire thing here, except for binary numbers. We did a different app on binary numbers, but this covered topic 2.2, data compression, topic 2.3, extracting information from data, and topic 2.4, using programs with data. Go ahead and finish.